Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I'm reading from the Dhammapada, a new translation by Gil Fronsdale, Chapter 1, Dichotomies. All experience is preceded by mind, led by mind, made by mind. Speak or act with a corrupted mind, and suffering follows as the wagon wheel follows the hoof of the ox. All experience is preceded by mind, led by mind, made by mind. Speak or act with a peaceful mind, and happiness follows like a never-departing shadow. He abused me, attacked me, defeated me, robbed me. For those carrying on like this, hatred does not end. She abused me, attacked me, defeated me, robbed me. For those not carrying on like this, hatred ends. Hatred never ends through hatred. By non-hate alone does it end. This is an ancient truth. Many do not realize that we here must die. For those who realize this, quarrels end. Whoever lives focused on the pleasant, senses unguarded, immoderate with food, lazy and sluggish, will be overpowered by Mara, as a weak tree is bent in the wind. Whoever lives focused on the unpleasant, senses guarded, moderate with food, faithful and diligent, will not be overpowered by Mara, as a stone mountain is unmoved by the wind. Whoever is defiled and devoid of self-control and truth, yet wears a saffron robe, is unworthy of the saffron robe. Whoever has purged the defilements is self-controlled, truthful, and well-established in virtue, is worthy of the saffron robe. Those who consider the inessential to be essential and see the essential as inessential don't reach the essential, living in the field of wrong intention. Those who know the essential to be essential and the inessential as inessential reach the essential, living in the field of right intention. As rain penetrates an ill-thatched house, so lust penetrates an uncultivated mind. As rain does not penetrate a well-thatched house, so lust does not penetrate a well-cultivated mind. One who does evil grieves in this life, grieves in the next, grieves in both worlds. Seeing one's own defiled acts brings grief and affliction. One who makes merit rejoices in this life, rejoices in the next, rejoices in both worlds. Seeing one's own pure acts brings joy and delight. One who does evil is tormented in this life, tormented in the next, is tormented in both worlds. Here he is tormented knowing, I have done evil. Reborn in realms of woe, he is tormented all the more. One who makes merit is delighted in this life, delighted in the next, is delighted in both worlds. He or she is delighted knowing, I have made merit. Reborn in realms of bliss, she delights all the more. One who recites many teachings, but being negligent, doesn't act accordingly, like a cowherd counting others' cows, does not attain the benefits of the contemplative life. One who recites but a few teachings, yet lives according to the Dhamma, abandoning passion, ill will, and delusion, aware and with mind well freed, not clinging in this life or the next, attains the benefits of the contemplative life.
Chapter 3, The Mind. The restless, agitated mind, hard to protect, hard to control, the sage makes straight as a fletcher the shaft of an arrow. Like a fish out of water, thrown on dry ground, this mind thrashes about, trying to escape Mara's command. The mind, hard to control, flighty, alighting where it wishes, one does well to tame. The disciplined mind brings happiness. The mind, hard to see, subtle, alighting where it wishes, the sage protects. The watched mind brings happiness. Far-ranging, solitary, incorporeal, and hidden is the mind. Those who restrain it will be freed from Mara's bonds. For those who are unsteady of mind, who do not know true Dharma, and whose serenity wavers, wisdom does not mature. For one who is awake, whose mind isn't overflowing, whose heart isn't afflicted, and who has abandoned both merit and demerit, fear does not exist. Knowing this body to be like a clay pot, establishing this mind like a fortress, one should battle Mara with the sword of insight, protecting what has been won, clinging to nothing. All too soon, this body will lie on the ground, cast aside, deprived of consciousness, like a useless scrap of wood. Whatever an enemy may do to an enemy, or haters one to another, far worse is the harm from one's own wrongly directed mind. Neither mother nor father, nor any other relative, can do one as much good as one's own well-directed mind.